I'm sure Private Gypsum told you why it brought you here.
Yes? Something about a... mission?
Indeed.
Now!
What's going on?
This is necessary for the mission.
What kind of mission requires holding me against my will?
An execution.
Execution?
This will happen so fast you won't feel a thing.
Where did that explosion come from? Was it me?
She's escaping! What do we do?
I need you to inform your troops and our subjects that they are at the task of finding her at the hunting grounds, and that they need to report immediately about her whereabouts.
Even if this is going to be tough, I just need to move on. Everything will be alright. But I do need some place to go. What? You know a place nearby? And it's close to a town.
Look! The lights in the treehouse are on!
Dumb Pony must have broken inside!
What if it's... him?
Seem more relaxed around us. Much better than before when you used to bully us at school.
That's only because I have no one else to turn to! Now that Silver's been transferred to a private school in Canterlot. To leave. Ponyville suffered long enough, and we don't need any more problems.
Diamond, stop
it! Please don't send me away. I don't have anywhere else to go, and they'll still be out there to kill me.
Nameless, I'm gonna talk to my sister, Applejack, about this. If I can convince her that you need the sanctuary, she might let you stay here.
Oh, thank you! Thank you! Thank you so much!
No problem.
You have disobeyed me.
But, Mother...
No buts! You have shamed yourself once again, my child. And for that, you shall be punished!
No! Mother, please! Please don't! I promise I'll be good! Mother, please! No! It was only a dream. I'm safe.
Litter by.
Huh?
Why in the world would we call her that?
How about something fitting like... destitute?
Come on, Diamond. Those awful changelings never gave her a real name. Giving her a new one might make her feel better. I wouldn't like being called something like Nameless my entire life if I was in her place.
Other than blank flanks.
What? I'm just proving your point. You don't have to glare at me like that.
Anyways, now we know at first glance, she is very shy, but also very nice. What name suits her best?
Maybe something flowery, like Rosy Posy?
Nah, that doesn't sound right.
She has wings too. Maybe it should be about flying.
And her cutie mark's a bunch of butterflies.
Ooh, how about Summer Rose? Or Rosy Skies? Aurora Belle? No, wait! How about Honey Glow? it!
Honey Glow! What? You want the bears to eat her?
Her coat is yellow!
What are you girls doing?
Oh! Good morning, Rosiebel! No, that doesn't fit.
Rosiebel? That's not my-
We know. We were just thinking of a new name for you.
A new name? Oh, you don't have to.
Look, it's bad enough that your mother and her army, I mean children, didn't want to name you. But it's worse if your name reminds you of unpleasant memories. So that's why we think of having a new name would help you forget everything about it.
Yeah, and you can have a new identity for a new life here in Ponyville.
A new life. That's very sweet of you girls, but what name should I have?
Well, so far we've got Rosie Posy, Flutterby, Honey Glow, something about Aurora, Butterwings, and that's it.
I'm not so sure about those names.
That's the trouble. None of the names we came up with seeming to be fitting you. We thought of something flowery or with butterflies or flying. Quick question. Are you a good flyer?
No. I was barely taught to fly. The best I can do is hovering above the ground.
Makes sense. The changes would teach you to fly like a normal Pegasus would if it meant you escaping.
Fluttershy!
Huh?
You can barely fly, but you flutter like a butterfly. And you were so shy you would greet Apple Bloom without shuddering last night. Your name should be Fluttershy.
Huh. You know, that name does suit her. What do you think?
Well, it does sound nicer than the others. And it has a nice ring to it.
Then it's settled. Your name shall be Fluttershy.
Welcome, Fluttershy!
Welcome, Fluttershy!
Thank you, girls.
Girls? I hate to break a heartwarming hug here. Really, I do. But we're going to be late for school!
Shoot, she's right!
We need to head out now!
Not without our bags!
Is there anything I can help you with?
That's okay, Fluttershy. We're good.
Is this school sort of like a training ground?
No! It's where ponies learn about basic things. Alphabets, numbers, social interactions, things you wouldn't understand.
I would ignore her.
And Fluttershy, I'll talk to Applejack about you after school and we'll see what goes from there.
That sounds good. That seems a long way to town. What if you get hurt?
It's fine. We each got an animal repelling remedy in our bags. A friend of ours made them for us.
Bye!
Goodbye. Well, I can start by cleaning up. I hope it goes well with Apple Bloom and her sister. I do need her permission to let me stay until the changelings forget about me. But she's never met me, and I don't know her well enough. What if she doesn't trust me and doesn't want me around in her town? What if the changelings find me until then? No, I shouldn't be thinking of that. If Apple Bloom said she can help me, then I trust her. I just need to be optimistic about the future. Huh? The pile almost looks like a face. Oh dear, I might have been too much in thought that I must have made it look like that.
Boo! You should see your face right now! It's exactly not the one you're thinking! Now the dramatic entrance is out of the way, let's get down to business, shall we? The name's Discord.
Lord of Chaos, Spirit of Disharmony. Call me whatever, the list goes on. Now ask me something, dearie. If I know every pony in and outside of the Everfree Forest, to which I do, by the way, how is it I can possibly miss an interesting little canary horse such as yourself? Well, since you're too shocked about my good looks and charisma, maybe I can guess the answers for you. Now let's see. Are you moving? No? Then how about traveling the world? Are you visiting? If so, are you related to the Apple family? I honestly hope not, because I find them a little irritating. Although you don't seem to have that country-like complexity they had it going on. I'll take that as a no. Well, if it's not one of those reasons, traveling the world or visiting a family, that would probably mean you're hiding something. But if you think I would consider your privacy and your feelings over such touchy topics, sadly, the truth is, there's no hiding from the Lord of Chaos. And the Lord of Chaos can't resist secrets.
I know I'm late, but I forgot my notebook. Discord!
Oh, hi there, Bad Seed. I wasn't expecting you to come in so early. You said you lost your notebook, right? Perhaps I can fix that. Oh, and look, you got the Chaos Edition.
Listen up, you freak. If you don't let it go, get out of the treehouse right now.
Hey, relax. I was only welcoming this precious little canary to a new home. I was going to leave anyway. I must say, my dear, it's been a pleasure meeting you. I do hope I see you again. Adieu.
Good riddance.
What the flying sheep?
Whoa!
Sorry, excuse my language, but still, who was he? How does he know me? How was he so powerful? Why have I never heard of anything like him before? Why did-
Slow down! You're gonna hurt your noggin if you keep babbling like that.
Do you know him, Paps?
I wish I didn't. In fact, all of Equestria knows him.
What?
I'm sorry you have to endure that, and I would tell you about it right now, but I really need to go back. Those might be close to Apple Bloom's home right now, and-
You still have time? It's only 7:40.
That wouldn't give me enough time to get to the schoolhouse.
Please! Just 5 minutes and you're free to go. Please!
Okay, I'll talk, but don't say I didn't warn ya. You might want to sit down.
What's that?
History book we got from school. We have others, but this one has pictures that can help you understand. Let me find the chapter first. Okay, here we go. I'm sure he mentioned himself as the Lord of Chaos to you.
Mm-hmm.
Well, he wasn't exaggerating. He's a draconiquist, species that no longer exists. Apparently, they were known to have the ability to bend the laws of reality with the snap of its claws. Over 100 years ago, or maybe 1,000, this could took over Equestria from the royals of Canterlot, sending every pony into a state of unrelenting torture. No pony before the princesses even managed to stand up to him due to the power he possessed, not to mention he's also a trickster. The princesses caught attention of the Sith at the same time and became the first bearers of the Elements of Harmony. In the end-
The Elements of Harmony?
They're very powerful artifacts, you know. The magic can bring balance to the land in any way possible. Your mother was even defeated by them in the past. Surprised she hadn't at least mentioned it to you.
I didn't know. I guess she didn't want to talk about it.
That must make sense. Must have ruined her pride. Anyway, the princesses used the element to turn discordance to stone, and everything went back to normal.
Wait, you said he was turned to stone. How was he able to break free from it?
I'm getting to that. You see, there's a prophecy that says that each time a meteor shower came across Equestria, the 6 ponies that were born on the same night would become the new bearers of the Elements of Harmony. But the thing is, once the princesses were disconnected from the element's power, their hold on Discord began to fade. So, the new bearers would cast the same spell on him, keeping him in stone again. It's been like that for the past few generations. But then something happened to one of this generation's bears when they were born.
What?
The bear went missing. I heard rumors, like she was like killed or something like that. But to be honest, nobody knows what happened. Either way, the connection became broken. Then Disco got free and escaped from the princesses. All of Equestria is still looking for him, but he always manages to slip away from them every time somebody sees him, including us. Applejack still didn't believe us after the first time it happened, but he's been doing this for a long time. He knows how to cover his tracks and get away with it, like snapping his chaos or shapeshifting to a new form. Make sense now?
I guess it does, but...
Well, it's been 5 minutes. I need to get to school before Miss Cheerily makes me tardy. Listen, Fluttershy, I told you all this to warn you. Not Disco knows you. You don't know what he might do to you. So you must stay away from him, and you mustn't tell him anything, including the changelings.
Don't you worry, Babs. I'll try to be careful.
Okay. Bye.
Well, it's about time. My, my, you jump as high as a grasshopper on a sugar rush.
What are you doing here?
Oh, there's nothing to fret. I was going to give you a welcoming gift before that brat barged in, so... Ta-da! What do you think? Is it satisfactory to your taste?
Well, yes, actually. It looks very nice.
Oh, something I found from the sewers of Manhattan. It almost got the guy who fought him. I'm guessing he was a plumber?
How do you make it stop biting?
Whatever it feels like it. You might want to feed him a few bugs. But careful. Their bite is worse than their appetite. Cheerio!
Oh dear.
Babs told us what happened. Are you all right? Whoa. Where did all these animals come from?
And is that plant from Discord?
From the way it looks, sweetie, it should be obvious.
He gave that to me as soon as he left. It took me a while to get him to stop biting, but my friends managed to help me by giving him wild berries.
That explains everything.
Are you okay?
Yes, I'm fine.
He isn't hurting you or anything?
No, he hasn't.
That's good to hear, but are you really gonna be okay?
What do you mean by that?
She means that, what we mean is that Discord is really strong. Really, really strong. And we don't want you to get hurt. And we can't do that much since we don't have magical powers and-
No, it's fine. I might have gotten scared at first, but I'll be careful. Really, it's okay. Besides, I don't think he'll be coming back.
I hope so. But if anything happens, just let us know. If you want, we know a friend who can help. She lives not too far away from here.
I'll keep that in mind.
Now that that's out of the way, we talked to Applejack after school.
Really? What did she say?
We told her all about you, but Applejack wanted to know you personally, so...
You're invited to dinner!
Dinner? With our family?
Yeah, you'll love it there. They have great food, not to mention the apples. They're the sweetest and juiciest apples in all of Equestria.
And they make the kind of family dinners where they make you feel like you're part of the family even though you're not related to them. Oh, I love family dinners!
Uh-oh. Did we come out a little strong?
No! Dinner sounds nice. It's just... it's all happening so fast and...
Hey, there's nothing to be nervous about. Applejack is the nicest, honest pony we know. She wouldn't hurt you.
And we'll be right by your side, including Applebloom. We can't imagine how hard it must have been separated from everything and all. But I'll bet that if you get to know the world a little more, you wouldn't be so afraid. But only if you give it a try.
Okay, I guess I can try.
Great! We can go right now since it's a long way to Sweet Apple Acres.
That's fine with me. Oh, wait a moment. Okay, little ones, time to go. Thank you. Goodbye. Sorry about that.
How did you do that?
I don't know. I had it for a long time. Ever since I got my cutie mark.
So, your talent is talking to animals? Oh, that's so cute!
Phew! Okay, that's the last tree for tonight. I'll get this bucket to the barn. One of you check with Granny, see if dinner's ready.
I'll go.
Oh, tonight is gonna be great. I can hardly wait for the girls to get here.
Well, I can't wait to meet your new friend. And it'll be nice to have time with my family after a long day in town. You know, you did the right thing coming to me with some pony in need. Though, from what you told me so far, it's safe to say this may complicate things. Especially with the ponies.
The girls and I thought about that too, but shouldn't it matter that she's new or not? She wouldn't hurt any pony.
I wish it weren't, but having an unknown outsider into town would cause superstitions about her. If we tell them about her and where she's come from, they'll think she's luring the changeling here to attack them. It's a lot of hooey putting hostility over one innocent pony, but at least I understand their concerns.
Oh.
But I'm still gonna help her regardless of what they think. We can keep this town striving and still give refuge to others. But I think for now, until the changelings are no longer a threat, we can keep her past a secret. It would be better for ponies and for Fluttershy.
I think so too. And the girls and I will always be by her side, so you don't have to worry too much.
I'm holding you onto that.
Girls, you're here.
Right on cue. Shall we, sis?
Girls, Fluttershy, you're right on time.
We just finished preparing the dinner table.
Glad to see you again, girls. You're Apple Bloom's new friend, right?
Yes, I'm Fluttershy.
I'm sorry, hon. I didn't catch that.
She's just a little nervous. This is the first time she left the treehouse.
Is it? Well, it's all right, Sugar Cube. There's nothing to be nervous about. The girls told me everything about you, including your name. I should be able to help you whatever I can.
Thank you.
I'll bet you're starving. We better get you inside and grab us some grub. Inside the house, girls!
All right, Billies, get to the table and no pushing.
Fluttershy, this is Granny Smith. And that standing over there is my brother, Big Mac.
Yup.
Hello there, young filly.
Nice to meet you.
My. You're as lovely as a cherry blossom in spring. I wouldn't mind if you and Big Mac go on a date.
Granny.
I'm just kidding. Big Mac's already got himself some in with that unicorn. He delivers our apples to her bakery.
Oh.
Come sit over here, Fluttershy.
Hey, where's that diamond tiara? I thought I saw her with you girls after school.
Her mother's having a huge dinner party tonight with her elite club. Diamond has to attend it.
Oh, well, I would like to have her come over sometimes to knock some sense into her.
What's an elite club?
It's a special kind of club Diamond's family's a part of. They're aristocrats, meaning they're rich. An elite club is where rich ponies like them go enjoy themselves.
As if drinking cocktails and acting and talking like zombies is fun for them.
Well, at least she gets to be with her family. Was it something I said?
No. It's just, let's say her mother isn't the most supportive or understanding type.
She cares about her reputation and status rather than her own daughter. The reason why we included her in our club is that we thought she needed a friend.
I'm sorry, I didn't know that.
That's all right. On the bright side, putting her on the team seems to help her a lot. She's getting more comfortable around us, and she's not as mean as she used to be.
What do you mean by that?
Alright, dig in!
Say, Fluttershy, you like apples?
Oh, I don't know. I've never tried one.
Dang! Those changelings are worse than I thought!
Granny! Well, I think it's high time you try one. You can take one from that bowl right there.
Oh, okay. Mmm, this is delicious.
Wouldn't be surprised. We harvest that ourselves. The finest apple orchard in the land.
Now, Granny, I wouldn't like to boast ourselves in front of our guest.
Well, I'm just saying. So, dearie, how do you like Ponyville so far?
I haven't been into town yet, but I'm sure it's nice.
Oh, you'll be impressed by how much has changed by dear Applejack here.
What do you mean by that?
Well, I won't brag too much about my granddaughter. But with the world going wonky over harmony and such, she took it upon herself to fix our home. Without her, we wouldn't have proposed fair trading with Canterlot, or security and plant control all over town if in the Everfree expansive territory again.
Yep.
Granny, she doesn't need to hear all that. Besides, I advise the mayor with the proposings. I'm just merely supervising. No big deal.
Aw, don't show yourself short, cuz. Well, no, right next to the mayor, you're the main leader. Ponyville won't be standing without you.
I bet it's a lot better than what your home was, Flutters.
Granny!
What? I mean it in a positive way. I wouldn't call it home if I were being mistreated all the time. Being born with no name is worse than being called a blank flank.
Blank flank?
Oh, them words were the name-calling the foals always use to describe a pony with no cutie mark. Dom and Tiara used to say that to Apple Bloom and Babs in the past.
What? I thought she was your friend.
She is. At least to us. That was way before we put her on our team.
Back then, she used to be their bully. But if it weren't for her, they wouldn't be crusaders today.
Really?
You're darn right. Well, I'm surprised you girls never told her this.
We really didn't get a chance to, Granny.
Well, could you tell me now? I'd very much like to hear it, if that's perfectly all right, I mean.
Why don't you? It's a great story.
Well, 2 years ago is when it all began. Cutie marks start popping up daily. It proves to us all we're no longer children. And in finding my mark, I was failing. And nobody picked on me more than Silver Spoon and that damn Tiara. But Granny says you just gotta keep on marching on.
Anyways, Babs moved here from Manhattan during the summer. It was awful at first, with her being aggressive and disrespectful to me and my family all the time. I used to have a grudge against her because of it. But then Applejack told me the reason why she moved here. It was that she was being severely bullied at her school for being a blank flank too.
We both talked about our problems, and by the time we became like best friends. It helped me a lot getting all that stress I had out, and I'm grateful I had someone as patient as Apple Bloom at the time, and I wouldn't have it any other way.
Us either.
Then our two big bullies set their sights straight on Babs. And we are gonna abide it.
We held them both after one big attack. And now we've been best friends ever since.
But sometimes bad guys need redemption. And when she was just all alone,
we decided to give her a chance to atone. Marching on.
Marching on.
We're all
Spiders on my way through the darkness and moving through.
Yes, marching to a better day.
We will find it on one purpose and a manner. What's the matter? We will shatter any break.
Is this what I've missed for the most of my life?
Aren't they just amazed?
They're my new family.
I wouldn't know how to be someone
who can go
moving,
marching to
a new day.
We're all crusaders,
finding our way through the darkness and moving through,
marching to a better day. We will find it,
our true purpose and a way.
Girls have been through a lot. How long have you been together?
For almost 3 years. If you want to include the time I moved here, I was 11 while Applebloom was a year younger.
Oh, you're older than you look.
Yeah, we kind of get that.
So, I've never heard of Silverspoon. Diamond's friend?
Oh, she moved to Canterlot a lot a year ago, when she'd been accepted to private school. Her family isn't fond of Applejack's values, so they wanted to be closer to higher society. Though, I was sorry for Diamond when she left. I mean, they were best friends.
Yeah, but at least we don't have to hear that sugar rump dance they do. That used to annoy the heck out of me. Well, that's pretty much about us. I guess since you told us yours, we're even now.
I guess so. So, I'm curious. How did you make that treehouse? And why is it in the Everfree?
I can answer that one. We actually had a treehouse in the orchard, but it got destroyed from a storm. I asked a good friend of mine who lives in the forest to build a new one, since she carved her home out of its trees. She also told me about a safe route from here to the forest the girls can take. Plus, I wanted them to be near her in case of emergencies.
She and Applejack used the part of her old treehouse to make the upper part of it.
This has been very lovely. Thank you so much, Applejack, for inviting me.
Well, I hope you come here more often. Now that you live here now.
You mean?
I'm giving you permission to live at the girls' treehouse. Until the deal with the changelings is over and forgotten.
Oh, thank you. Thank you so much.
It's my pleasure, Sugar Cube. But from now on, you can't tell any pony about the changelings. The ponies here ain't ready to face such a panic. And if there's anything that you need, simply come to me or my friend Zakora. She lives not too far from the treehouse.
I will. I promise. Thank you again.
Scootaloo. Babs is here to pick you up for school.
I know, Auntie Holiday. I'm heading out now.
Hey, not without your lunch, Squirt.
Thanks, Auntie Lofty. See you later.
Okay, bye-bye.
Have a good day, honey.
Ready to go?
You bet I am.
You think Fluttershy will be okay on her own?
I hope she is, as long as Discord doesn't come back for her again. I wish we could do more than just warning her about him.
It's the only thing we can do now. If we told someone to capture him, he'll disappear just like he always does. Don't worry, Scoots. If there's any trouble, we'll be there for Fluttershy.
You're not at least a tad worried that she'll be alone with him?
A little. I would hate to think what it would do with her.
Good morning. Oh, jeez, that never gets old.
What are you doing here?
Oh, nothing special, really. I came to see how you slept.
I slept okay. Is that all?
Well, actually, I was wondering that maybe, just maybe, that I would, oh, I don't know, hang around here for like a day or two.
You want to hang around here?
What did you think I wanted? A bag of sugar? I just thought that being here your first time in this forest and living here all alone, you would like some company.
Don't you have a home?
I like to consider the entire world my home. I like to come and go as I please. But for now, I like spending time here with you.
You're not supposed to be here.
Oh, really? I don't recall them saying I can't come in for a visit.
Well, I live here now, so I think you should leave.
You think? Tsk, tsk, tsk. Is that any way to treat your guest? I thought you would be a little better than that since your escape from those changelings.
You saw me with them?
I'm guessing you knew them. They wouldn't be if they were going to kill you for no reason.
How much did you see?
Not much. I heard you screaming from a distance, running off to where you fell, having a sweet heartfelt moment with those little fluffballs, and then everything just fell into place. It's like I said before, my dear. There's no hiding from me. And if you want those changelings to stay clear from you, then you must let me stay as your guest. Is that clear?
Okay, you can stay.
Excellent! Now, do you have some pancake mix? Because I really need to go for those right now.
Oh, what have I done? I promised the girls I'd be careful. And look at this. But if I kick him out now, he might bring me back to Mother and... Okay, today's going to be tough, but I'm sure you can handle this, Fluttershy. You can handle this. When is this going to end?
Quite a day for swimming, isn't it? Though it doesn't compare to turning the room into a roller rink and a badminton field.
Or turning the stairs to soap, the furniture into food, or making magical brooms to clean the pancake batter off the walls?
Maybe so. The Parasprite invasion in the bedroom was a bit of a letdown, though. Why don't you join in the fun? The chocolate milk is nice and warm.
I don't know how to swim.
Well, there's a first for anything. If you would give it a little...
No, thank you.
Well, you're certainly a tough cookie to break. Maybe some music to relax you. Feeling better?
Oh, how am I going to get out of this?
Come on, girls. Fluttershy's in danger. We never should have left her alone.
It was a good thing we saw this one make the treehouse float and twirl in the air. Might be tricky to get it up there, though.
Won't your mom get mad at you when she noticed you're gone, Diamond?
She has a meeting with a client. I doubt she'll notice a thing. At least I have something to do in the meantime.
Seems like the animals are worried about Fluttershy, too.
Oh, when I get my hooves on that no-good bully, he's gonna regret the day he was born. No, Scoots, you can't fly that high.
How else are we gonna get up there? All we got here is a bunch of woodland animals, 3 earth ponies, 1 unicorn, and 1 weak flyer.
Wait, sweetie, can you do levitation spells?
A little. Why?
Can you float yourself up there?
Are you crazy? My magic's not strong enough to lift myself. I have to be like a wizard to do that. The best I can do is to lift objects.
Maybe you can lift one of us up?
I could, but that will mean one of us has to face Discord alone.
I'll go.
All right, get ready.
Get me closer to the door.
on now. Just one splash. Whoa!
Quick, behind the trees!
Ah! My mouth's getting dirty!
Ours too, you know.
But Mother would notice this! She's going to kill me!
What the? What happened to the... Why, I'm surprised. I never thought you would be this daring.
Apple Bloom!
Fluttershy, we saw the treehouse floating around after school. We thought you were in trouble.
Daw, isn't that sweet? A young squire trying to rescue the fair maiden from the hideous dragon. Why don't I reward you with a caramel apple? Don't worry, your treat is perfectly safe. But if I were you, I would keep it away from the para sprites.
The para what?
Stop it! Leave her alone! She didn't do anything wrong!
Oh, please! What makes you think you can get me to stop all of this chaos I created? You probably didn't plead those changelings hard enough to save yourself.
I said stop! Leave her alone and turn everything back to normal!
But our deal...
I don't care! Do it now!
Apple Bloom!
The treehouse is back on the ground!
No, get out. I said get out!
Fluttershy? Are you okay? Fluttershy!
What do we do now?
Hey! What happened to your bow?
Who's there?
No need for alarm. I mean no harm. I can vow with the truth in my eye. There's no need to fear, Fluttershy.
How do you know my name?
Applejack did tell me earlier this day, seeing you pleaded for a place to stay.
Wait, are you Sakura?
Indeed, I am.
The girls told me about you. I'd forgotten you lived near them.
I'm merely here to pick herb valuable in the moonlight, though it is strange to see you in such a fright out here in the night.
I had a bad day.
You might need to ease your mind. Perhaps a visit to my hut will help you unwind.
No, I should go. The girls might be worried about me.
I promise I'll bring you home if you choose to come. The girls will understand in time.
Okay.
Come with me, and while we're on our way, you care to tell me what happened today.
Okay. Well, this morning, I woke up alone in their beds. I knew that the girls stayed at their home. And that's when I ran outside.
I see. Please take a seat over there. I'll bring something to share.
You're not from here, are you?
I would advise you not to judge and stare. It is more than I can bear.
I'm sorry. I didn't mean to be rude, but you look so unique.
Your observations I can quite understand. I am a zebra, very far from my land. Tea always helps me to relax. Would you like to take a chance?
Sure. This is lovely. I've never tried this before.
I could imagine, especially on what happened.
Did Applejack happen to mention Mai?
She had me entrusted in secret. To others, I won't say a word. But what I want to focus on is a mess of emotions that you dwell upon. It is all right, my dear. You've done nothing wrong. But why you look so torn?
I don't know what came over me. I was so angry. I've never yelled at anyone before. Not even around my mother or siblings. I just hold my emotions in check just to keep myself safe. But today, from the way he was treating me and the girls, I couldn't take it anymore.
You should not worry about releasing your emotions. They are gifts from life's potions. The more you hold it in, the more pain it'll be within.
But why do I feel so guilty about all of this? I've been trying my best to live on my own since I ran away. But sometimes, I don't even know what I'm doing. I'm not as strong, smart, or brave as the girls or Applejack. I don't even know about the world. Maybe I am as weak and worthless as my siblings said.
Life has been hard on you, I can see that. You run from the past that leaves you bruised and harassed. But you shouldn't fret for this hurting alone. That for others, it is something they had known.
Like who?
I can give you a few examples. Perhaps your young hostesses. And that criminal rascal?
The girls? And Discord? No, that's not possible. The girls are sweet and mature. They have a strong bond.
You forget that they are still looking for their cutie marks, all the while dealing with such cruel remarks.
I know that. But they're strong. They don't let it bring them down. And Discord, he hurts ponies everywhere he goes.
I can understand your doubt. That I can't joust. But through his villainous schemes, he is not as evil as he seems.
How would you know? He's nothing but a monster. I didn't mean to yell.
I know through him you are torn, but trust that I've seen it before. It is a part of the pony condition. Every pony learns through their grief and ambition. And all of your flaws come through when their emotions are true. You are running from your demons, but your fears intensify. The children had grown, but with no purpose for life. The Draconicus had been freed, but with no one or no meaning. You all have something worth seeking.
I might not think of it that way, but are you sure that's what they're feeling now?
Through my observations, it might be true. It can only be decided through you. But the truth I give you is most sincere. They are as lost as you are, my dear.
I'll keep that in mind.
Good to hear, Fluttershy. And now it is time that we say goodbye. Let me guide you home so you can learn in time.
In time for what?
For when you would like to come over any time, if you need some pony to confide.
Thank you. I'll definitely visit you.